Being unstoppable in the UFC is a very rare thing to happen. However, in recent years, we have seen a glimpse of unstoppable forces in the UFC who have achieved a certain level in their career where they have looked unbeatable for a brief moment. So for this video, I will be talking about the 10 unbeatable fighters in the UFC. Number 10. Antibiotics Rockhold. After defeating Lyoto Machida by a rear naked choke at UFC on Fox 15, Luke Rockhold earned himself a title shot at then UFC middleweight champion Chris Weidman at UFC 194. Just 2 weeks before the fight, Luke Rockhold would catch a staph infection and would be given antibiotics to help him recover. On the day of the event, the antibiotic in his stomach erupted, and something strange started to happen. All of a sudden, his focus was heightened and his awareness was raised to a new level. He had never felt a power like this before, and it seems as though he reached a new level. A new level of certainty, a level where his fighting abilities were enhanced by the second. It was at this moment, Antibiotic Rockhold emerged with powers like never before. And with these new powers, he was focused on one thing and one thing only, and that was to gain the UFC middleweight strap. In the fight, he would push forward in a very intense battle, where in the fourth round, the antibiotics would kick into the highest limit, which would push Antibiotics Rockhold to finish Chris Weidman by TKO to become the new UFC middleweight champion of the world. Antibiotics Rockhold is a very dangerous human being and was an unstoppable force at UFC 194. Number 9. Toronto Max. Every time Max Holloway has fought in Canada, a feeling of excitement has always overtaken him, where the whole country embraces him.
What island is it?
This type of energy has helped Max bring a new side out of him, a side that only shows up when he's in Canada. This side is also known as Toronto Max. Toronto Max has always showed up in Canada with heightened speed and aggressiveness, where he has just overwhelmed his opponents. At UFC 206, Toronto Max faced Anthony Pettis for the interim UFC featherweight title. Toronto Max would harness his inner power and gain focus where he was ready to go to war. Toronto Max would finish Anthony Pettis by TKO, winning the interim title. Toronto Max would show up again and would dominate Brian Ortega at UFC 231 in Canada, eventually getting the TKO doctor stoppage victory. Toronto Max would overpower Frankie Edgar at UFC 240, winning the fight by unanimous decision. Toronto Max is a force to be reckoned with and is undefeated in Canada. Number 8. Game Plan Garbrandt. Game Plan Garbrandt would always have a game plan and was calm and collected inside of the octagon, which gave him great success as he came up the rankings. Game Plan Garbrandt would find openings out of nowhere and would use his speed to absolutely crush his opponents. This was seen when he impressively dethroned then champion Dominic Cruz in an emphatic fashion, becoming the new UFC bantamweight champion of the world at UFC 207. After winning the title, he was involved in an intense rivalry with TJ Dillashaw, where Game Plan Garbrandt got angry and aggressive and lost control and reverted back to his normal form, known as Cody Garbrandt. This is where the game plan went out the window and he started brawling. This would cost him dearly, as he would lose his title to TJ Dillashaw at UFC 217, and he would lose the rematch by TKO, and would get caught up in a reckless brawl with Pedro Munhoz at UFC 235, losing the fight by KO in the first round. Game Plan Garbrandt was a dominant force in the bantamweight division, and will be remembered for his great patience and clean striking inside the octagon. Number 7. Cabo Nate. When Rafael dos Anjos pulled out of his fight with Conor McGregor at UFC 196, Nate Diaz, who was on a yacht in Cabo partying, was given the call to step up on 2 weeks' notice and face Conor McGregor in a welterweight bout at UFC 196. Nate Diaz would immerse himself into training and done what he could in the 2 weeks he had to prepare for the fight. His body began to see changes, his chin became iron, and his conditioning was enhanced tenfold. When the smoke cleared, he re-emerged as a new fighter, a new being, and would now be known as Cabo Nate. In the fight, we saw Cabo Nate's ability to withstand damage was taken to a whole new level as Conor McGregor hit him with his best shots and wasn't able to put him away. Cabo Nate eventually tagged Conor McGregor in the second round, stunning him, and was able to get the rear naked choke finish. Cabo Nate is one of the most durable fighters when he is called on short notice, and his victory over Conor McGregor was arguably one of his best performances in his UFC career, where it showed that he's always ready for war, even if he is partying in Cabo. Number 6. Humble McGregor. Humble McGregor made his UFC debut against Marcus Brimage at UFC on Fuel TV 9. In the fight, we saw his fast movement and his accurate striking completely shut down Marcus Brimage, finishing him by TKO in the first round. After winning UFC gold at UFC 194, he would lose his humbleness and became overconfident, where he would make the mistake of looking past his next opponent, Nate Diaz, at UFC 196, where he would lose the fight by a rear naked choke. Humble McGregor would make his return at UFC 202 and would avenge his loss and next demolish finished Eddie Alvarez at lightweight, becoming the first dual champion in the UFC. Upon making his return, Humble McGregor lost his humbleness once again and overlooked Khabib at UFC 229, which cost him dearly, where he would lose the fight by a neck crank in the fourth round. Humble McGregor would once again make his return at UFC 246, where we saw a change in his physical appearance. Something was different. He was laser focused and calmer than ever. In the fight, he would demolish Donald Cerrone in just 40 seconds of the first round, winning the fight by TKO. Humble McGregor is an assassin, and once he is laser focused on his opponent, he is definitely an unstoppable force in the UFC. Number 5. Triggered Khabib. At UFC 229, Khabib Nurmagomedov was set to make his first title defense against former dual champion Conor McGregor in a 5-round bout. At the pre-fight press conference, Conor McGregor would insult his father and called his manager a terrorist. Upon hearing this, Khabib's mood changed. Something didn't feel right. An empty void appeared inside Khabib, where a rush of emotion came out to the surface. Khabib was disrespected like never before. The raging anger deep within his being erupted, where Khabib Nurmagomedov was no more. An eruption of deep emotion deep inside of him came out, and a new being came forth known as Triggered Khabib. When both fighters entered the octagon at UFC 229, Khabib looked cool as a cucumber, but inside there was a rage that needed to be unleashed, a rage that was brewing for months on end, and now he had the man in front of him. This is the moment where he let go of his emotions and embraced his new form and unleashed his anger like never before. He was able to drop Conor McGregor with the overhand right and was able to smash him on the ground, eventually getting the submission victory. Triggered Khabib is a very scary man and should be avoided it at any cost. Number 4. 30% Usman. At UFC Final 124, Kamaru Usman was set to face Emil Mick in a 3-round welterweight bout. When Kamaru Usman and Emil Mick entered the octagon, Kamaru Usman felt a change inside of him, as if he was being drained. All of his energy was being zapped out of him, and what he didn't realize that he had lost 70% of his energy and was running on 30%. The emergency power supply deep inside of him kicked in, where out of nowhere his abilities were heightened. He felt a sudden force of energy surrounding him, where it was clear that he reached his final form, known as 30% Usman. In the fight, 30% Usman was able to block Emil Mick's kick with his head, which showed that his resistance to damage was almost bulletproof. In the second round, he would eat a spinning back fist like it was a birthday cake and kept marching forward like a maniac. He would absolutely smash him on the ground, bloodying him up. In his post-fight interview, he would reveal that he was at 30%.
I fought this fight sitting at about 30%. Everybody knows what I'm capable of. That was 30% right there, and I still dominated a tough so-called Viking.
The emergency reserves served him well in getting a dominant performance. We have only seen 30% Usman once in the UFC, who has proven to be a deadly challenge, and he is certainly an unstoppable force in the UFC. Number 3. C-Level Kane. C-Level Kane was one of the most dominant forces in UFC history. He was known for his enormous gas tank and his ferocious beatdowns he put on his opponents. His endurance was enhanced beyond the normal limit, where this man would not get tired whatsoever. C-Level Kane didn't seem to have any weaknesses, but once he faced Fabricio Werdum at UFC 188 in a title unification bout in Mexico. In this fight, his biggest weakness was revealed. This weakness was altitude. When both fighters entered the octagon, C-Level Kane looked calm and composed, where he was ready to do what he normally does, which was to maul his opponents. As the fight began, C-Level Kane started off strong, but was seen to fade away as the fight progressed, where he became sluggish in his movements and his conditioning did not help him one bit. He was easily getting tagged by Fabricio Werdum and desperately went for a takedown in the third round, in which he ended up in a guillotine choke and was forced to tap. C-Level Kane is a force to be reckoned with, but once he is forced to fight outside of his comfort zone, his ability to fight is affected severely. Number 2. TRT Vitor. In 2013, Vitor Belfort re-emerged from the depths of hell in his final form known as TRT Vitor. All of his attributes hit the full meter mark and just looked like a very terrifying human being. His new heightened abilities made him into a walking weapon as he developed the ability to end a fight with a single strike. The immense power surrounding him gave off an intimidating aura where he just seemed too dangerous to deal with. TRT Vitor made his first appearance when he faced off against Michael Bisping at UFC on FX7. He would KO Michael Bisping via a head kick in the second round in a very violent way. He next knocked out Luke Rockhold via a spinning heel kick in the first round at UFC on FX8, and lastly knocked out Dan Henderson via a head kick in the first round at UFC Final 32. After three very violent finishes, he was next in line for a shot at then UFC middleweight champion Chris Weidman. The Nevada State Athletic Commission banned the usage of testosterone replacement therapy, where TRT Vitor was no more. Both fighters eventually faced off at UFC 187. Chris Weidman absolutely destroyed him in the first round, winning the fight by TK in the first round. TRT Vitor's violent finishes have left a mark in the sport, where he will always be remembered as one of the most brutal finishers in the history of the sport. Number 1. Bare Knuckle Artem. In 2019, Artem Lobov moved on from MMA and set his eyes on bare-knuckle boxing, where we truly saw what he was made of. At bare-knuckle FC 5, he was set to face former UFC fighter Jason Knight in a 5-round bout. Artem Lobov prepared himself for the fight of his life and put full concentration into his training camp. A short time passed and Artem Lobov re-emerged as a new fighter, a new being, a new body, a new mindset. This wasn't the Artem Lobov we knew. Once the smoke cleared, it was at this time we found out that he had achieved a new level. He had ascended past just as an average MMA fighter. He emerged as Bare Knuckle Artem. Bare Knuckle Artem made his way to the ring and something was very different about him. There was an aura of uncertainty where nobody knew what to expect. As the fight began, Bare Knuckle Artem would use his powers to detect the movement of Jason Knight and threw thunderous strikes which had Jason Knight wobbling all over the place. His fluidity inside the ring had crushed Jason Knight's state of mind and he was just losing a battle that he couldn't win. After a very bloody and grueling fight, the unanimous decision was given to Bare Knuckle Artem. He would next face former professional boxer Paulie Malignaggi, where he would take all of his shots using his granite chin and would push forward in a very tactical fight, where after the 5 rounds the unanimous decision was given to Bare Knuckle Artem. Even though he would lose his next fight to Jason Knight in the rematch, Bare Knuckle Artem showed that he has great heart and determination and is not scared to throw down with his opponents. MMA fans have developed some sort of an obsession with this man, where they really appreciate what he brings when he fights and is certainly one of the must-see fighters in the combat world. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked this video, please make sure you hit that like button and hit the subscribe button and the bell to be notified when we post videos. So that was my video of the 10 unbeatable fighters in the UFC. Let me know your thoughts and comments in the section below.